Hey, what's up guys, this is your friend Maina from Civil Center and welcome all of you back to our channel in yet another video on estimation. So friends, today we'll tell you about our course on building estimation and we'll also tell you why you should join that and according to your aspirations. So basically, we'll know about the course first. Basically, the name of the course is your G+1 building estimation. So what does estimation mean? What is the role of an estimator? We have made several videos. But basically, estimator is a person who determines the quantities of various construction materials and also determines the cost of a particular constructions. So here, every civil engineer should know some basic estimate and he or she should be able to calculate the material and the cost involved in a particular project. That's why the estimation is very important. So this estimation for a civil engineer or estimation for a building is similar to the estimate of anything which we make in our day-to-day life. Suppose we want to go to a particular place. Suppose we want to give the birthday party of one of our friends. Then what do you do? What do you do? We contribute, let's say, 50 rupees, 100 rupees from each person so that our estimated price can be met. Whatever will go on the travel expenses, the food expenses at the restaurant and other, party decoration stuff. So all these things we estimate and after that we, divide it among ourselves so that we can give the birthday party. So like this, we use estimate in our daily day-to-day life. Estimate in civil engineering, particularly estimate of building, is simply calculation of the quantities and determination of the cost so that before making a building, your client for whom you are doing the estimate can know how much material will be required and how much cost of materials will be required, what will the cost of the labor also. So all these things, your client or the owner of the building can know. That's why the estimate of the building is done. And also, who have to do it? If you're a building consultant, then you might need to have to do it. You have given the plan, you have given the structural drawing. Then you have to do the estimate also for your client so that they can use it. And apart from that, you have job roles as estimator as well, where you need to perform the estimates. A site engineer also, the estimate comes in very handy. Like you have to take into estimate what is the material available at the site and what will be the materials which will be required in the future as per the given structural drawings and the architectural plan. So it's very important to know that. So Civil Center is here to guide, and we are soon starting our new batches for estimation. You can join that. So we'll be discussing today about that particular thing here today. So that's why we'll be doing here. So basically, I'll just walk you through our course content on building estimation here. What are the things we are covering here? So we're covering here. So as you can see, the name of the course is G+1 building estimation. So it is a 15-hour course. It takes up to 20 classes along with the 20 to 25 classes along with the practice and all. So introduction to the estimate, what is estimate, what is the need of the estimate, all these things are covered here. Architectural and structural drawing study. It's very important. You should know how to study the architectural and structural drawings of a particular project. So you can also see that. So as you can see in this particular project, if I can show you. So this is the architectural plan which contains all the dimensions and all. And this is a structural drawing which contains the details of all the structural members, how to study them. If you are to do the estimate of that, you have to understand the drawing first. So how to understand the drawing that is shown here, and then basic introduction to MS Excel has been given, because we will be doing the estimate in MS Excel, because that is an easy tool. And any repetitive calculations you don't have to do. You can set some programs also so that you can work around smartly. So all this can be done using MS Excel. So that's why we are introducing you to MS Excel. And then BOQ of a core house. So core house means, what does the core house mean? Core house means your basic amenities like the earthwork, excavation, and then the particular concreting, shuttering, all building construction works up to plastering. So it will cover excavation. It will cover your footing casting, column casting up to the first floor level or whatever level you are doing, beam casting, brickwork, plastering. So what will not cover is the painting works, electrical works, plumbing works. So these things will come under the finishing works. So the core house BOQ will cover in that. And then the bar bending schedule. So the bar bending schedule is very important, because through the bar bending schedule, you will get to knowing the particular total quantity of reinforcement. So as you know, in a building, the total cost is determined mainly by the steel, that is the rods, and as well as the concrete. So concrete consists of, as you can see, the brick, sand, and your cement, sand, and coarse aggregate, and the rod. So its bar bending schedule enables you to find out the quantity of the reinforcement accurately with the help of the structural drawings. You have accurate calculation. We have our IS code also for the rod binding. So using that, we find out the bar bending schedule, exact length of bar required, and after that we can get the total weight or the total quantity or the pieces of bar as well. Then BOQ of finishing works, all the finishing works BOQ, like the painting, the putty, plastering and all. So this finishing works, we are covering the BOQ. And then the abstract preparation. Abstract preparation contains of your like the total, the cost of the project, this quantity wise, like for the earthwork, there is the quantity is this much, and the total, your cost and quantity are, done in put in separate columns, adjacent columns. And after that, the market rate and analysis. So this is very important. So we have some analysis of rates. We have some analysis of rates of PWD as well and some other organizations as well. But whenever you need to give the estimate of a particular project, you need to know the market rate. So how to collect those rates of the materials, how to collect the rates of the laborers or the contractors, we'll also show you that. So this is what is covered in this particular, course of the building estimation. And let me also tell you about the price, because we are very transparent about everything here. So as you can see, the price of this particular project, training, which you can see here, is this one. As you can see, G+1 building estimation, the training fee is ₹4,000. And in this, we'll cover all these topics. And next batch is going to start from next week. In fact, every month we are doing two batches. So if you are watching this video, you can have yourself enrolled using the link which has been given in the description. You'll find the link which has been given in the description. So that's all for the promotion. So now we'll just show you some of the knowledgeable things which can be helpful to you. Before that, I want to introduce you to the Civil Center Student Club. And if I can show you this. So basically, this Civil Center Student Club is one of our efforts to create a platform where civil engineers can unite. So basically, we are dealing with the concepts of what makes a civil engineer. So what makes a civil engineer because we are given a 4-year degree or BTEC or some diploma. And after that, we go out in the field. Some of us want to open our own company, and most of us want to, get a job in some reputed organization. Then we are introduced to the fact that we need certain skills. Even for site engineer, we need some skills. Even for a drafting job, we need some skills of basic CAD. Even for a structural design field, we need StatPro or any other design software like Tekla Structural Designer, ETABS or something, and STAD. So if you want to become a 3D designer, then we know that we need the 3ds Max, SketchUp, Revit. So these things, so all these things a civil engineer requires. Even for project management also, there are different softwares. So after graduating, most of us know. But our effort is that before you graduate, you can choose your field. So how we can choose your field effectively, in which field you want to go? It depends on interest. When you know your interest, when you know everything. So is it possible to know everything in the market? The question is yes. If you go for it to any training institute and you go through the fees or structure of them, if you learn all these courses, it will take up to 1.2 to 1.5 lakhs for learning all of this. But Civil Center is here to guide, and Civil Center is here for the students. So that's why we have launched our Civil Center Student Club. And in this Civil Center Student Club, we have this technical activities, extracurricular activities, and non-technical activities as well. So all these courses are covered in the Civil Center Student Club, and it contains your G+1 building design using AutoCAD and StatPro, and then the G+1 3D modeling using SketchUp and Revit architecture, and then estimation, the course which I'm telling about, and then the MS Excel, and then building design using MS Excel. This is a very interesting one, because you can, those of you have interest in the structural design field, and this is for those of you who want to go in the structural design field as well, Tekla Structural Designer. This is for the structural detailing field. And the next is for the structural detailing field, for creation of structural drawings, BIM software, survey, if you are interested in pursue your career in the surveying field to become a surveyor, or even so that you can pursue this field, even as civil engineer, if you have the knowledge of surveying. So this we have, you know, practical training, field training also in this particular course, and then project writing skills and also assistance on some specific topics like this. So we, in addition, we are also giving, like, if you want to become a consultant, you need to have some additional skills like MS Office, graphics design, because nowadays as a civil engineer, the more the skills you have, the better you go. So all the skills also we are giving here, and group discussions, video editing, mock interviews, career counseling. So mock meeting sessions, industrial specialist talks. So everything we are including here, even some extracurricular activities we used to include in the post lockdown era, but right now it's not possible. So now the Civil Center Student Club contains, this is the bronze membership, silver membership and gold membership. Gold membership will contain all the courses and all the activities. Silver membership will contain some of the activities, and bronze will contain basically the workshops and all the online meetings. So that's what these contains of. So if you want to join, you can contact the number which of Om Sir, which has been given in the description. You can contact him using that. So coming back to our estimation, so let's also gain some practical knowledge of the estimation field, so that you can have an idea, even if you are, whether you want to join the course or not, what is the field of estimation, you can know that. So that's why we want you to have a basic idea of our course. So let's start here. As you can see, this is what I'll share with you, one of the structural drawing here, and I'll share with you the screen. And here you are having the structural drawing here. As you can see here, this is the structural drawing of some footing. So basically, let's see the basic process of estimation for you. So we'll just open the estimation process, and we'll show you the basic of the all the process to your estimation. So estimation, what is estimation, what are the things which has been covered in the estimation field, what is the role of an estimator, everything we'll cover up to now. So let's start here. And so basically, as you can see here, I can show you properly, this is a G+1 building estimation. So if you are not knowing what is a G+1 building, G+1 building is basically a building which is ground floor plus one floor above it. So this is basically a G+1 building, and a G+1 building full estimate will cover. So let us see what are the steps which are involved. First of all, let us know what is estimation, roles of an estimator, we will all know. So estimation is basically the determination of the quantities of the all the works which has been done. So determination of the quantities can be done by using simple mathematical calculations. And the next thing is your determination of cost. So determination of cost can be done by market rate analysis. So estimation can be equals to quantity determination of the project and the cost determination. Quantity determination by simple mathematical calculation, cost determination by market rate analysis. That is what an estimation is. Roles of an estimator, it comes under collecting the costs, submitting quotations. And if you are working in an organization to participate in the tenders as well, for that also you require the estimation. And you, if you want to monitor the different stages of the project, that's also you need the estimation. Suppose you are working a project, so you should know what are the current expenses and what will be the future expenses. So suppose we are going for the shuttering work of the columns of a building having 3,000 square feet area. So you are calculating the cost of the shuttering works. And after that, you can also compare that after the actual costing has been done. So if there is anything to be corrected, that also you can incorporate. So like that, an estimator learns and according to the various situation. So as an estimator, you should know the construction steps also. What are the construction steps? Basically, if you have this piling, we were going to piling works. If there is a deep foundation, then the piling works will undergo. Otherwise, there will be your normal excavation. So these are the drawings for the piling work. We'll explain them in our course. What are the details? What does the drawing mean? And then we will go for the excavation. Excavation is for the isolated footing, as I've told you. So after the marking, the excavation is done, and the quantity of the excavation is found out in a meter cube. So as you can see, he is calculating the length, breadth and width of the excavated portion of the earth. And after that, the excavated earth need to be disposed. So there is disposal. and there the particular excavated earth is then filled with sand for footings. There is 100 mm sand filling below it and up to the plinth level. Inside the periphery wall, the remaining sand filling is done. ECC is done after above the sand filling of the the foundation, plain cement concrete 1:4:8 ratio, and PCC is also done in places below the beams where the we don't have any walls. And then RCC is done. RCC is reinforced cement concrete, is done for all structural members, beams, columns, slabs, staircases. And after that, the shuttering materials, all know about the shuttering. Shuttering is done for all the structural members where the RCC is done. These are the shuttering for your columns. And then the steel reinforcement, which is the important thing. Now we have an average formula to calculate the steel reinforcement, that is 1.5% of the volume, or else we can accurate steel reinforcement, we can calculate using the BBS or the bar bending schedule. These are the rebars for your footing. And then the periphery wall, as I have told you, the periphery wall, inside the periphery wall, we are having sand filling, and around the periphery wall, we'll have the beams, which are called the plinth beams. And inside also, we'll have the interior plinth beams, below which we can give PCC. So the periphery wall brickwork is mainly used to hold the sand inside it, and also to maintain a level which is called the plinth level, that is the height of the building above the ground floor, in which we are stepping in the ground floor. So there can be different kinds of brickworks based on your brick available. There's some people prefer 9-inch brickwork in the outer walls and 4-inch brickwork in the inner walls. Some places there are 10-inch in the outer and the 5-inch in the inner, including plaster. So according to that, you have to calculate the brickwork and external and internal brickwork, and then the plaster. You can have the inner plaster, slab plaster, and the outer plaster. So all have a different dimension. 19 mm for is the standard for the outer plaster, 12 mm for the inner plaster, and the 6 mm for the the slab plaster. It can vary according to your standard conventions and this various places. Some running meter plaster is also there for some places which are unconventional, like along the sides of the window, below the staircase. So like this, some people also incorporate that into consideration because the rates are different for those plastering those places. And then the study of the architectural and the structural drawings, it's very important. It should be done at the front. And after that, you have to explanation of the drawings, basic unit conversion, everything will be covered. And the market rate analysis is important, as I've already told you, to know the different rates of the different materials and cost of the things involved in the market. So if you want, you can also ask any questions in the comment section. And till then, I will also just show you some of the sheets of the estimation which are prepared, so that you can have an idea of the materials which has been used in the estimate. So these are the BBS of beams. As you can see here, BBS of beams, as you can see, the length of the total beams have been calculated. And after we calculate the length of the total beams in the below, we'll find the total weight of the different bars. So if we calculate the different weight of the bars, then you can calculate, find out the number of pieces of reinforcement which will be used. So if you can find out the number of pieces, you can easily find out the number of your, what will be the cost of your project. So like this, we are doing different things. And the final material quantity normal estimate can also be done using, like, suppose you have the earthworks. So whatever is the quantity or which has been used for the footings. So these are all simple mathematical calculations, length, breadth, multiplication, height. But how to do it in format, if you want guidance and if you want proper guidance from us, you can join our estimation session using the link which has been given. And I will also give you the link of the recorded session. So if you can't afford the price currently, because currently, as you can see, the situation for all, we are knowing the current situation for everyone. So if you are not able to afford that, you can also, you can also connect with us for the recorded session also, that is at a minimum price. But if you want, if you can afford it, you should definitely go for this particular estimation course, because it will help you in the process of becoming a civil engineer, in the process of realizing your goal. The more the skills you have, the better. And find someone who is trained enough and who can guide you properly in this process. And if you choose us, we are happy to work with you, and we are excited to teach you new things and also get some input from you as well. So that's all for today's video. If you want to enroll in our session, you can do so in the link which has been given in the description. And if you want to go for the recorded session, which is the lower price, you can also go for that. So whatever the case, just hit the like button because it really helps the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to learn, there are lots of videos in YouTube which Civil Center has uploaded. You can simply go through that and you can learn a lot of things about estimation, about structural design, about 3D design. So the field is free for you. Just one, we have one request, that hit the like button because this helps the YouTube algorithm. And if we reach to more number of people, then we also do something for you. So with that, we'll end today's session. Keep learning and stay safe. Bye-bye.